For years, there was a gap in the market for a transcontinental jet that could seat 100 to 150 passengers to be used on less busier routes. Airlines had to use the old DC-9s or smaller variants of the 737 or A320, which was still too big for the job. When Bombardier introduced the C Series, it was such a revolutionary plane in its class that made it a big threat to other aircraft manufacturers. Boeing didn't have anything good enough to rival the C Series, and so it decided to try stopping it. We all know about the duopoly of Airbus and Boeing in the commercial aircraft market. Almost every jet aircraft that seats about 130 or more passengers are sold by them. However, the market for smaller narrow-body regional jets are controlled by two other companies. They are Canadian company Bombardier and Brazilian company Embraer. When the C-Series entered service in 2016, airlines fell in love with it because of its low operating costs. Passengers like it because it has a quieter, more spacious, more comfortable and better air quality cabin, not to mention its big overhead compartment. Bombardier had managed to integrate all the latest technology into it, something that hadn't been done to any other plane in its category. Having said that, it came at a cost for Bombardier. The C-Series was Bombardier's first entirely new aircraft. Developing it was trickier than expected and took a huge financial toll on Bombardier. The company had to borrow a lot of money to fund the project. At the end, it was billions of dollars in debt to the point that the Canadian government had to bail them out. In short, the C-Series was a huge gamble by Bombardier. Fortunately, it came out with the goods as the C-Series turned out to be a great plane. This made Delta Airlines, a leading US carrier, to order 75 firm CS-100 aircraft valued at around $6 billion. This angered Boeing and prompted the company to take action. Boeing filed a complaint saying that illegal subsidies from the UK and Canada for the development of the C-Series helped Bombardier to sell the plane below its production cost. The claims were denied by both the UK and Canada. In September 2017, the US Commerce Department announced a proposed combined duty of up to 300% on every C-Series sold in the US. Since Bombardier was already in trouble financially, this high tariff could not only kill off the aircraft, it would also potentially drive its manufacturer to the ground. In retaliation, Canada threatened to cancel plans to buy 18 F-18 Super Hornets from Boeing, while the UK threatened to review future purchases from the US company. But Bombardier has one last trick up its sleeve. On 16 October 2017, Bombardier announced that it had sold a 50.01% stake to Airbus, not of the company itself, but of the C-Series program. The deal was very well received by investors and financial community. By combining Bombardier's revolutionary aircraft with Airbus's global reach and scale, the C-Series program would be able to unleash its full potential. Not only that, Airbus announced that it would build a final assembly line for the C-Series at its factory in Alabama for those sold to American airliners, a move that Airbus claimed would allow the aircraft to avoid the import duties. The deal appeared to catch Boeing off guard. Boeing later called it a questionable deal and said it had no effect on the tariffs. But ultimately, it didn't really matter. In January 2018, the US International Trade Commission rejected the proposed tariffs. The nonpartisan and independent commission ruled that Boeing had not been injured by the Canadian subsidies for Bombardier. Airbus later rebranded the C-Series aircraft family as the A220-100 and A220-300. To date, there are more than 500 orders for the A220s.